Welcome to Carrizozo Music. Carrizozo Music is a nonprofit organization celebrating its 14th year, and it is dependent on grants, foundations, and your generous donations. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we have moved all of our music to a virtual platform for you to enjoy any day and any time from the comfort of your own safe place. Part of the mission of Carrizozo Music is to provide school outreach programs, including concerts, workshops, lectures, and demonstrations for the children of New Mexico, many of whom live in impoverished communities and never have the opportunity to experience this type of culture. Performances are funded in part by the New Mexico Humanities Council, New Mexico Arts, National Endowment for the Arts, Western Arts Foundation, Otero County Electric Cooperative Operation Roundup, Tularosa Basin Telephone Company, Zia Gas, and listener donations. Throughout the performance and afterwards, we will answer your questions via our email, carrizozomusic@gmail.com. All emails will be answered within 48 hours. Please visit our website to watch and listen to the many great performances we have in our performance library at carrizozomusic.org. Remember, donations from you, the viewer, are important to the success of this organization. Thank you.
Welcome to this concert of the Palmetto Winds Woodwind Trio, performed in West Stockbridge, Massachusetts, and presented by Carrizozo Music. Before we begin, I'd like to thank some very important institutions and individuals without whom we would not be able to present this concert. Our heartfelt thanks go to Western States Arts Federation, the National Endowment for the Arts, Carrizozo Music Incorporated, and viewers like you, who have all made generous donations. Thank you. Piece, I'd like to introduce the musicians. My name is Catherine Hudgins. Also on clarinet is William Hudgins. And Wren Saunders plays bassoon. Our next piece is the Divertimento No. 3 by Mozart. A divertimento is a piece that was very popular during Mozart's day. In the latter part of the 18th century, they were often played for parties at the grand estates of upper-class patrons. A divertimento is a light piece intended to entertain the listener.
Thank you. Thank you.
Tchaikovsky. But I wonder how many of you have heard that famous melody played on the bassoon. In my work as an arranger for this ensemble, I felt some pity on my bassoonist colleague for often having just a bass line or accompaniment to the clarinet melodies so much of the time. So I decided to give the bassoon a starring role with this lush melody, the canzonetta from the Tchaikovsky Violin Concerto.
Thank you.
Arcangelo Corelli was an Italian violinist and composer of the Baroque era. Corelli composed a remarkable total of 48 trio sonatas. The trio sonata was a new genre of music that featured multiple movements and was played by two treble instruments and one bass instrument. The first known trio sonatas were written in Italy in the early 17th century. Corelli's beautiful sonatas likely influenced many other later composers. You could almost consider him the king of trio sonatas.
Thank you.
Was an incredibly prolific composer. At his death, he had published approximately 100 compositions, but many more unpublished works were later found. His numerous works consist of songs, symphonies, chamber music, church music, and music for the theater. Some of my favorite music of Schubert's comes from the incidental music to a play entitled Rosamunde. I have arranged two of the pieces which we will now play, the entr'acte number 2 and the ballet music number 2. In order to give us more variety of musical colors, I have arranged this piece for a B-flat and an E-flat piccolo clarinet instead of just two B-flat clarinets.
Thank you. Thank you.
Stefano Mascagni was an Italian composer known primarily for his operas. In July of 1888, a music publisher announced a competition open to all young Italian composers who had not yet had an opera performed on stage. 25-year-old Mascagni heard about the competition rather late, so he quickly began to compose the required one-act opera. On the final day, he submitted his composition, and his opera was judged to be one of three finalists. When his opera, Cavalleria Rusticana, had its premiere, it was an instant success, winning the competition, and with Mascagni receiving 40 curtain calls. Our next piece is an arrangement of the beautiful intermezzo from this opera.
Thank you. Thank you.